Using gold as currency is not free from weaknesses, as it has many disadvantages, said a UKM economics professor on 21st July 2011. Professor Dr. Mansur Jusuf from the Faculty of Economics and Management, giving his inaugural lecture on losing control of money, financial stability and inflation control, said because gold is a commodity, it could be taken out of circulation for profiteering and would result in increase of its price. This will cause deflation and even worse, resulting in a lack of currency for trading. He said these two situations will not help to handle a crisis, but only will make it worse. The gold currency doesn't ensure financial stability or price stability and is prone to deflation. Right now, the money in use is valued using the floating exchange rate mechanism, or fiat money, where the money issued by the government of a nation is declared as legal tender and thus accepted for trade. This is where the value of currencies is determined by the market forces. In a fiat financial system, there is no restraint on the amount of money that can be created, thus allowing for unlimited credit creation, whereas using gold as currency, the amount of money available for circulation is limited by the amount of gold that is available in a particular country. Islamic scholars and intellectuals have urged the world to go back using gold as currency because it was recognized as a financial system that is more stable and practiced during the time of Prophet Muhammad. But Professor Mansur said the using of gold as currency is not an Islamic system. Before the time of Islam, the Arab of Mecca and Medina has been using gold and silver, which were introduced by the Romans and the Persians. He said that fiat monetary system, if accompanied by sound policy implementation, can in principle ensure price stability. He argued that the perception of fiat money is the cause of usury by some Muslim is misleading. Based on economic consideration, it is difficult to imagine any country that would switch the present system to a gold system, which has failed in the past. It does not ensure price stability and can force the government of a country to give up its control on currencies, when its value could be determined by international commodity market. Vice Chancellor Professor Tan Sri Dato' Wira, Dr. Sharifah Hapsah, Syed Hasan Shahabuddin, deans of faculties, senior universities officials, lecturers and students attended the lecture.